This is the Marriage Podcast, and I'm your host, Alexandra Stockwell. I'm a physician turned relationship and intimacy expert, and I specialize in showing couples how to have incredible, passionate relationships. I myself have been married for 25 years. My husband and I have 4 children and full professional lives, and we've created an amazing relationship. If you want to deepen your understanding of your own relationship and learn to access new heights of emotional, sensual, and erotic intimacy, you're in the right place because I will show you how. Let's dive in. Hey everyone, this is Alexandra, and I am so excited for this interview on the Marriage Podcast. We have Ben and Monica Tanner joining us. And the thing that's so amazing is that Monica and I, we were both guests in a summit, and I don't even remember what summit it is, but I watched the interview with Monica and I'm like, I want to talk with her because the two of us have so much in common. We've been married approximately the same number of years. We both have 4 kids. We're devoted to our wonderful husbands, and we're also relationship and intimacy coaches. Both of us have some traditional training and are mostly drawing on life experience and what we've learned from the couples that we've coached. So I'm meeting Ben for the first time, but I feel like I know you, Ben, a little bit because you shine through all of Monica's work. So I'm really grateful that you're both here. And with that introduction, would love to invite you to share a little bit about who you are, your business, what you want the listeners to know before we dive further into the conversation.
Yeah, well, we're really happy to be here. I remember having the same feeling about you hearing you speak. I was like, oh my goodness, we are going to be friends. So that feeling was definitely mutual. My husband and I have been married for just under 20 years, actually. So we're a little bit behind you, but we do have 4 children, 2 boys and 2 girls. And so 2 of them are teenagers. So there's lots of activity at all times in our household. And we're both entrepreneurs. So we both have our own businesses that we love. And I love to talk all things relationship and intimacy. Well, my husband prefers to keep a little bit more private.
Anything you want to add to that, Ben?
I think Monica nailed it. I try to stay below the radar and just, you know, keep everything personal for the most part. And Monica is kind of opposite of that in that regard. So,
well, you know, I have a question for you because so much of what Monica shares is about the life you share together. You're individuals, you're a couple, your family. And recently I asked my husband, you know, how do you feel about my sharing so much personal information online? I used to be the much more private person in my marriage, but I've overcome that because I know that telling these stories serves people and they learn what's possible and how to create things and what's normal. Anyway, I said to my husband, how do you feel about my sharing so many details about our lives? And he said, as long as it's true, I'm okay with your saying it. Because his life is much better since I've become a relationship coach. But I wonder, how is that for you to be a private person, but have Monica share kind of intimate details about the love you have for one another?
You know, I liked your husband's response because I would say the same. I'm not really bothered by it. I know Monica is very passionate about it. And it's not like she's making things up. She's sharing our real life, which, you know, is nothing to hide from. For sure. But she really enjoys it. And so I just kind of go along and let her do the talking and, you know, keep to myself mostly.
He's very supportive on the sidelines.
You know, I really love that you say that because I think sometimes, especially in our modern environment, couples at the beginning of their relationship think things need to be equal. Like if one person's passionate about something, the other person's supposed to be too. If one person is talkative, the other one really needs to contribute to the conversation too. But I actually think there's so much juiciness in respecting that each person has their own way of doing things and that the collaboration and synergistic effect of that and real respect for each person's individual way really adds a kind of foundation that passion is built on. What do you think, Monica?
Well, I absolutely agree with that. And I teach that so much. I love that dynamic in a relationship. And I always try, I love to help people, especially in the area of support and get and feeling supported by their spouse. And I always try to kind of debunk this idea that your spouse needs to be passionate about what you're passionate about in order to be supportive. And I always say that couldn't be farther from the truth. Like, for example, I'm passionate about online marketing and intimacy, and my husband is not. Like, those are not his things, but I'm his thing. He can still be passionate about me without getting really excited about intimacy and online marketing. Same as I can still share with him things that are important to him, like sports and coaching and things like that, coaching kids in sports and things like that. He gets really passionate about those things that I don't really get passionate about, but I love watching him do it. And so he's my thing, but his things aren't necessarily my things. And so I think we need to be really careful about thinking that we have to have the same passions or the same interests in order to have a really passionate, enjoyable relationship.
I love so much how you've said that. And I know a lot of your work really is in teaching people how to feel supported by their spouse and as well as how to support them. And I'm curious, is that a hard won lesson, or did you come into your marriage being really clear about that?
No, that's a very hard won lesson, definitely. I think we've spent a lot of time sharing with each other things that we enjoy. And it wasn't until I learned that he really likes watching me do my thing, even if he doesn't get excited about doing my thing or being a part of my thing. Same with him. Like, for example, he coaches a high school soccer team, and I love watching that varsity soccer team. I get so excited. Like, watching him coach and do his thing is so exciting to me and makes me love him so much more, even though I would never be over there on the sidelines doing what he's doing, right? But I love watching him get really passionate, excited about doing his thing. And I feel like he probably feels the same way about me. When I get really excited and passionate about something, it's kind of who I am and what I love. And it gives me confidence, and it gives me, you know, a dimension and things like that. But he definitely doesn't get excited about those things like I do.
I love hearing you say that. And I have to say, with all respect for Ben's unique position, it's very easy to be excited watching you be passionate. I think you're just really good at being passionate about the things you're passionate about. So you make Ben's job a little easier than it might be for some people. And really, that is something for all women to pay attention to. Like, when we love what we're doing in a generous way, it is much easier for our men to support us, our partners to support us. And actually, this leads into the question that I ask everyone, because I really believe that relationships are the ultimate context for personal growth. And so I'd love to ask each of you, what have you learned about yourself as a result of being in relationship with one another? Monica?
You want me to start?
Yeah.
I think that I've learned, well, my goodness, I've learned so much. But I think for the purpose of this interview, I've learned that in following my heart and doing what I'm passionate about, it makes me better at everything that I do. So, you know, I've kind of found this spark, as we could call it, about helping marriages and relationships. And like you said, it's been a hard won battle for me. When we first got married, marriage, I was so worried about being a good wife and a mother that I studied it incessantly. And so I thought I was all well equipped to do it. And then when I started doing it, it was so hard. And I realized I had no clue what I was doing. Even though I wanted to be so good at it, I had no idea how, right? But through learning about all of that experientially and, you know, coming out on the other side, learning really who I am and that who I am is good and that I have something to contribute in the world beyond just being a wife and a mother, which is awesome. Being a wife and a mother is awesome, but feeling like I'm contributing in another way with the lessons that I've learned, the hard-won lessons that I've learned throughout time, it makes me a more confident, better mother and wife, right? So I feel like a rising tide raises all ships. And so as we come into who we are and what we were meant to do, I feel like then we really can serve from a full cup and from our excess, rather than always feeling like we're giving, giving, giving of all that we have and never getting anything in return.
I love that. And you model that so well. Ben, what would you say you've learned about yourself as a result of being Monica's husband?
You know, I would say that I've learned that I can still love Monica and listen to her and support her. Yet, you know, what she does is not appealing to me at all. Like I don't, like we said, I don't like being the forefront. I don't like being the voice. I love what I do, but I can still love her and what she does. And that's fine. And everything's okay. And that also, you know, helps us have things that we discuss and go back and forth on, because I'm not in that world. I don't do podcasting or social media. I'm not into that at all. But yet I can hear, you know, the things that she does and struggles with, and I can listen to her and hear her out and not even give opinions, because I don't even know what I'm talking about, right? So I can just listen, and that works out great.
I love hearing what you say, because there's so much magnetism and appeal, and the love between the two of you is so evident. And I think in this really delicious way, the two of you exquisitely model what good boundaries are. Even though neither one of you use that word, you're really describing like the power of connection that directly comes from having good individual boundaries. I am so excited. I can't wait to have you back for a longer conversation. I hope Ben will be willing to participate again. And in the meantime, for anyone who does want to learn more from you, Monica, and hear your teachings and be able to really implement being a better support and being more supported, what's the best way to find you?
Yeah, so you can find everything on my website on thebrightersideofmarriage.com. There you can find links to my podcast On the Brighter Side of Marriage for Entrepreneurs, as well as The Vault, which is a really cool resource where entrepreneurial spouses talk about their relationships and the lessons that they've learned, kind of building their empires and their families together. And then the course that I have coming out soon will be linked there as well. So you can find lots of free resources on www.onthebrightersideofmarriage.com.
Yeah, we'll definitely have all the links in the show notes. And I want to invite you to just give a little teaser, because you have some pretty big name people who've contributed their stories and wisdom in the vault. I think anyone who's in the online world for entrepreneurs has heard the name of some of your guests. Anything you want to drop as like little teasers for the deliciousness in that opportunity?
Yeah. So this month in the vault, we have Russell and Colette Brunson, who are the creators of ClickFunnels, as well as the CEO, Dave and Carrie Woodward. In their interview, they talk about how to raise entrepreneurial children, which I think is really valuable. Russell and Colette talk about their journey and the things that they wish they had known and done differently, which is really cool. And we've got Lauren and Justin Golden. We've got Anika and Akbar Sheik. So many incredible. And these are all people that have made $1 million in their business. And they've done it with learning lessons about juggling the demands of marriage, family life, children, and their entrepreneurial businesses. So yeah, there's some really great names in there, but there's also some great marriage experts and business experts that will be in the vault, like you and your husband, who will be sharing with us your journey and the things that you've learned about marriage as well. So the vault is such a great treasure trove of resources if you're looking to build a business, you know, have a strong, thriving relationship as well.
Okay, well, it just sounds so incredible. And I invite everyone to look it up. Everything that you produce and share is the same informative, dynamic, generous way that the two of you have been on this show. And I look forward to talking again soon.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining me for this episode of the Marriage Podcast. Please rate and review the show on iTunes. It really makes a difference. And if you have a question or a comment, reach out to me via my website at alexandrastockwell.com.